Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we are going to discuss properties of vector product. Property 1 states that the vector product is not commutative, rather vector A cross vector B is equal to minus of vector B cross vector A. Let vector A and vector B be two non-zero non-parallel vectors . Let theta be the angle between them where theta lies in between 0 and pi and let n cap be a unit vector perpendicular to both vector A and vector B. Here we have vector A and vector B are two non-zero and non-parallel vectors and theta is the angle between vector A and vector B and n cap is a unit vector which is perpendicular to both vector A and vector B. Then by definition we have vector A cross vector B is equal to A into B into sine of angle theta into n cap, or we can also write it as modulus of vector A cross vector B is equal to A into B into sine of angle theta, and mark this equation as 1 where the orientation is anticlockwise and is taken as positive. Now, similarly we have modulus of vector B cross vector A is equal to B into A into sine of angle theta. Here, orientation is clockwise. And we can write modulus of vector B cross vector A as A into B into sine of angle theta, as we have AB is equal to BA. Hence we can say vector A cross vector B and vector B cross vector A are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Therefore vector A cross vector B is equal to minus of vector B cross vector A. Next we have the vector product of our vector, say vector A with itself is a null vector, that is vector A cross vector A is equal to 0 vector. As angle between the vectors is equal to 0 degrees, that is the value of theta is equal to 0, therefore sine of theta is equal to sine of 0 degrees, that is 0, which implies that the value of vector A cross vector A, that is vector A into vector A into sine of 0 degrees into n cap, will be equal to 0, since sine of 0 degrees is equal to 0. 3 is that vector product is associative with respect to a scalar. Thus, if vector A and vector B are any two vectors and M is scalar, then M into vector A cross vector B is equal to M into vector A cross vector B is equal to vector A cross M into vector B. Let theta be the angle between vector A and vector B, and let M be a scalar. Then the following cases arise. Case 1, when M is greater than 0, here theta is the angle between vector A and vector B and M is a scalar. Then we have M into vector A and vector A are in the same direction, and vector B and M into vector B are also in the same direction. Therefore, M into vector A cross vector B is equal to modulus of M into vector A into modulus of vector B into sine of angle theta into M cap, which is equal to M into A into B into sine of angle theta into M cap, which can be written as M into A into B into sine of angle theta into M cap, which is equal to M into vector A cross vector B. Also we have vector A cross M into vector B is equal to modulus of vector A into modulus of M into vector B into sine of angle theta into M cap, which can be written as A into M into B into sine of angle theta into M cap. That is, we have M into A into B into sine of angle theta into M cap, which is equal to M into vector A cross vector B. As vector A cross vector B is equal to AB sine of angle theta into M cap. Now we have M into vector A cross vector B is equal to M into vector A cross vector B, and vector A cross M into vector B is equal to M into vector A cross vector B. Therefore we can say M into vector A cross vector B is equal to M into vector A cross vector B and is equal to vector A cross M into vector B. Second case is when M is less than 0, here theta is the angle between vector A and vector B. In this case, M into vector A and vector A are unlike vectors, and so the angle between M into vector A and vector B is pi minus theta. And here M into vector A, vector B and minus M cap form a right handed system. Therefore M into vector A cross vector B is equal to modulus of M into vector A into modulus of vector B into sine of angle pi minus theta into minus M cap, which is equal to modulus of M into modulus of vector A into modulus of vector B into sine of pi minus theta, which is equal to sine of theta into minus M cap,
since m is less than 0, therefore modulus of m is equal to minus of m into a into b into sine of angle theta into minus of n cap, which is equal to m into a into b into sine of angle theta into n cap, which can be written as m into vector a cross vector b, where theta is the angle between vector a and vector b, and again m into vector b and vector b are unlike vectors, and so the angle between vector a and m into vector b is pi minus theta. In this case, vector a, m into vector b and minus of n cap form a right-handed system. Therefore, vector a cross m into vector b is equal to modulus of vector a into modulus of m into vector b into sine of pi minus theta into minus of n cap, which can be written as modulus of vector a into modulus of m into modulus of vector b into sine of pi minus theta, which is equal to sine of theta into minus of n cap. Now modulus of m is equal to minus m, since the value of m is less than 0. So we get minus m into a into b into sine of angle theta into minus of n cap, which is equal to m into a into b into sine of angle theta into n cap, which can be written as m into vector a cross vector b. So we have got m into vector a cross vector b is equal to m into vector a cross vector b, and vector a cross m into vector b is equal to m into vector a cross vector b. Thus, in this case also, we get m into vector a cross vector b is equal to m into vector a cross vector b is equal to vector a cross m into vector b. Now case 3 is when the value of m is equal to 0. In this case we have m into vector a cross vector b, which is equal to 0 vector cross vector b, that is 0 vector. Since m into vector a is equal to 0 into vector a, which is equal to 0 vector. Also we have vector a cross m into vector b is equal to vector a cross 0 vector, which is equal to 0 vector. Since m into vector b is equal to 0 into vector b, which is equal to 0 vector, and m into vector a cross vector b is equal to 0 into vector a cross vector b, which is equal to 0 vector. So in this case also, we get m into vector a cross vector b is equal to m into vector a cross vector b and is equal to vector a cross m into vector b. Hence, from all the cases, we have m into vector a cross vector b is equal to m into vector a cross vector b and is equal to vector a cross m into vector b. Property 4 is distributive law, that is, for any three vectors, vector a, vector b and vector c, vector a cross vector b plus vector c is equal to vector a cross vector b plus vector A cross vector C, let vector A be equal to A1 I cap plus A2 J cap plus A3 K cap, vector B be equal to B1 I cap plus B2 J cap plus B3 K cap, and vector C be equal to C1 I cap plus C2 J cap plus C3 K cap. Therefore, vector A cross vector B plus vector C, where vector A is equal to A1 I cap plus A2 J cap plus A3 K cap, and vector B plus vector C is equal to B1 plus C1 into I cap plus B2 plus C2 into J cap plus B3 plus C3 into K cap, can be written in the determinant form as: the determinant containing elements I cap, J cap, K cap, A1, A2, A3, B1 plus C1, B2 plus C2, B3 plus C3. On solving this we get A2 into B3 plus C3 minus of A3 into B2 plus C2 whole multiplied by I cap plus A3 into B1 plus C1 minus of A1 into B3 plus C3 whole multiplied by J cap plus A1 into B2 plus C2 minus of A2 into B1 plus C1 whole multiplied by K cap, and mark this equation as 1. Now, vector A cross vector B, where vector A is given by A1 I cap plus A2 J cap plus A3 K cap, and vector B is given by B1 I cap plus B2 J cap plus B3 K cap, can be written in the determinant form as: the determinant containing elements I cap, J cap, K cap, A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3. On solving this we get A2 into B3 minus A3 into B2 into I cap plus A3 into B1 minus A1 into B3 into J cap plus A1 into B2 minus A2 into B1 into K cap, and mark this equation as 2. Now, vector A cross vector C, where vector A is given by A1 I cap plus A2 J cap plus A3 K cap, and vector C is given by C1 I cap plus C2 J cap plus C3 K cap, can be written in the determinant form as: the determinant containing elements I cap, J cap, K cap, A1, A2, A3, C1, C2, C3. On solving this we get A2 into C3 minus A3 into C2 into I cap plus A3 into C1 minus A1 into C3 into J cap plus A1 into C2 minus A2 into C1 into K cap, and mark this equation as 3. Now, adding equation 2 and equation 3, we get vector A cross vector B plus vector A cross vector C is equal to A2 into B3 plus C3 minus of A3 into B2 plus C2 4 multiplied by I cap plus A3 into B1 plus C1 minus of A1 into B3 plus C3 4 multiplied by J cap plus A1 into B2 plus C2 minus of A2 into B1 plus C1 4 multiplied by K cap and mark this equation as 4. Since right hand side of equation 1 and equation 4 are equal, so their left hand sides are also equal. Therefore we can say vector A cross vector B plus vector C is equal to vector A cross vector B plus vector A cross vector C. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.